Oh, dude.
Get in there.
No, what are you trying to do?
Put the small to the bottom.
Into my tummy?
Into the shirt.
Oh, that is not how smells work.
Yeah, but if you're covering this and I just like...
That's not how smells work.
It could be, though.
It'll just go... You can't just like smell bend.
Oh,
you're stupid. Do I sound congested?
You sound dumb. All right, buddies, we're back, and we're uglier than ever. We put in zero, this might not look different to some of you, but to me it does. We put in zero effort for the way we're dressed, because the point of the video today is that we're going to dress each other up. Oh my god. Gage and I went to the thrift store yesterday. That's where poor people go.
Yes.
And we're poor people. That was not a diss. We are poor people. And we separated and picked out clothes for each other that are outside of the realm of the aesthetic that we normally dress in. So I'm going to dress up in the clothes that Gage got, and he's going to dress up in the clothes that I got him.
I'm curious to see you outside of...
I'm going to hate it.
You are going to hate it. Here's the thing. Because she's dressing me up the way that she thinks I'd look good. I am, one, bad at this. I have zero style. Most of my own style is influenced by you. So it's going to be a hodgepodge.
It'll be interesting.
Of shit.
It'll be very interesting. I'm excited. I can't speak for what Gage got, because I don't know what he got, but I am very excited for what I got, and it will surprise no one.
Bing!
Foot!
Oh, no! you got nasty croc foot. Those should be fucking breathable.
You guys
want to
see what I can do?
Those should be breathable.
I am a warrior. All of this because you gave women the right to vote, you fools!
We shouldn't. I'll go on a record
okay.
now.
Okay.
Hello, everybody. I am going to try and walk you through Brittany's makeup here that I chose for her style, as you can see from the picture there. I found a super, super cute girl on Pinterest. I liked the style. It fit kind of what I was going for, and I wanted to go with something that she had never done before, and something that she would honestly hate, because that's just fun for me, and that's what I did. It's called Bohemian. Some of you may be familiar with it, some of you may not. It's kind of a festival look. It's kind of a hippy dippy, earthy, you know, loose vibe. It's pretty cool looking, and again, just something that she's never done before, and I wanted to see what she could do with it. As much as I know she's gonna hate it, I know she's gonna do well with it, because she is actually really good at makeup. I don't wanna like admit anything, but she's pretty good at makeup. I also want to point out that in this part right here, as she's doing her eyebrows, I don't know makeup that well. I don't get it. I've never been someone that's like understood the like appeal or the difference that like shaping and drawing on eyebrows, or like people spend a lot of money to get those little, like, they put floss on your eyebrow and they go kind of crazy with it, and I just never really got it. I'm probably the only one that thinks that, but I mean, I just, you know, it is what it is. I'm also being told, or I've also been told, that the reason that she left right there was because she had to go pluck some unibrow hairs. So I'm just going to call her out and let you sit in that, because now she has plucked them, and good job. And the other things that I wanted her to do with this was pick blue and earth tones. She does not like earth tones. She hates blue. Again, just trying to push her out of her comfort zone. But this looks nice. I like the brown that she chose. I actually think it's going to fit really well with the clothes. It'll fit perfectly with the pants. And, yeah. Good job. Okay, we're back to the eyebrow. Back to the eyebrow. I digress. You know what? That looks really... I was wrong. that looks really good. Wow. It actually makes such a big difference. They're just like, they stand out and shape her face so much. Oh my God, was I the wrong one the whole time? I'm an idiot. No. Well, here we go. Okay, to the blue. She's putting on the blue. That's nice. I think that'll blend really well. I also, again, for the third time, don't understand makeup that well. But every time I've seen someone do it, very impressed, first of all. But second, it always just looks like kind of bad. Like, it looks like it's just kind of a blotch of colors that go in together. And then all of a sudden, there's like one. It's like the draw things that you used to see where it was like make a circle, then like add like your grid, draw a few details, and then finish the dragon. And like every step just looks like so casual and small and just blobbed on. And then all of a sudden they finish the dragon. It looks insane. So I don't get it. I don't really get it, but clearly she does. And we'll see what she comes up with. Okay, some more brown. A little more earth action. Oh, there's glitter in it too. That's fun. That'll fit the theme. I like that. Good for her. And the other thing is too, I'm sure she's gonna say something about this. Putting on makeup is so like aggressive and painful. The way that you have to get into your eyelids and all like your sensitive places on your face is, it hurts so bad. And it makes me so uncomfortable. I'm really sensitive about it. I don't understand why. But every time she puts makeup on me, I just squirm like a little baby. I don't like it. But she's handling it like a champ. Oh, a little highlight. That's fun. That's nice. That looks really good. The white, the brown, that pops. That's really good. I know she hates it so much, but that's really good. Look how disappointed she is. She's pissed. She matched the opal, though. That's also fun. Throwing the wing on. Classic. This is the one place she'll feel at home. I don't know if wings are typically included in Bohemian, but we'll take it. Pretty. Okay. Ooh, big wing. Also, she's using the Jeffree Star palette. Shout out to the palette being great, but fuck Jeffree Star. I say it. I'm not afraid to put that stance on our channel. There it is. Blood sugar. Wow, that really changed things. Holy shit, that looks good. Alright, maybe I'm the idiot. Good job. That looks pretty good. And then, okay, the white dot. Yeah, no, that's perfect. That's exactly what I was looking for. And an earth lip to close. Beautiful. Easy, breezy, beautiful. We're not sponsored, so I won't finish their jingle for them. I'll make them pay for it. Nice. I think this turned out exactly like I was expecting. I'm happy with the results. And a dot to close it. How fun.
Your brar?
My brar.
Perfect.
I think it's a good brar, right?
I mean, it's a fucking brar, dude.
I just wanted to know, I resisted the urge to just like...
Why?
I don't know. Okay, I need you to close your eyes and go like this.
Just so everybody knows, Gage is the worst person to put makeup on. Every single slight, if a molecule on my finger touches a molecule of his eyelid, he can't handle it. It like tickles the shit out of him. Another struggle that I went through here was that Gage's eyelids are very small. It is not free real estate. Which you wouldn't guess by how generous I'm being with the product that I'm putting on, which is primer. Gotta keep that eyeshadow down, baby. So the look that I was going with here is like that grungy, gothy e-boy. So I'm just caking on black eyeshadow, which, in Gage's defense, really makes his eyes pop. He should start wearing incredibly heavy eyeshadow from now on, I think. But as you can see here, he struggles to keep it together because he's very delicate. He's got the same sensitivity as a clitoris. So I just do what I do what I can with what I got. You know what I'm saying? I don't pick the battlefield. God does, you know. So I use the skills that God gave me, and I do what I can with them. The eyeshadow I'm using is literally from a like $15 palette from Amazon. So not really gonna go through the whole makeup process. Yeah, there's a lot of fallout from that shit. He looks unwell. Just caking it on. It's the important thing when you're going for the e-boy goth grungy look is to just make them look as sickly and as tired as possible. So that's really my inspiration. I'm just getting every single crevice of his little tiny eyelid. You know how you're born, you have like your baby teeth, and then like when you get older, your adult teeth come in? I feel like Gage still has his baby eyelids when he was a baby. I'm doing the underlid now, which was very challenging for Gage. He's like ascending to heaven. Looks like he's being raptured. Jesus is coming back for him right now. Look at him. Looks like he sees God. Yeah, he thought that was funny. He made the craziest face right here. It was wild. I literally had to keep taking breaks because it looked like he was fucking going through it. It looked like he was being abducted, like straight up. I'd never seen such awe and fear in a man. It was pretty great. Just cleaning it up a little bit, you know, keeping it tidy like I do. I'm here, I'm giving him shit about being raptured. Yeah, clean it up. Nice and tidy. Keep that pussy tight, as I say. Which I think that can apply to any situation in life, honestly. If I'm being 1000% fair to myself. Like I said, caking it on is really my process here. Just putting as much dark eyeshadow on as I can. So, just pack it in the corners. But he looks Egyptian a little bit, which honestly was kind of a vibe, so. Got my Sailor Moon brush. Stir it up, girl. What are we doing now? What is this? What are we doing? I don't remember what this is. Oh, you know what it is? I'm gonna do his freaking eyebrows. I'm gonna fill them brows in. Oh no, I'm just touching his bottom eyelid again. He's trying to not to just like completely arch backwards. He did pretty good. Really powered through at the end there. Oh yeah, what a trooper. Just wants to run. Look at him, look at a little raccoon boy. He looks just like his picture on the back wall. What an inspiration. I do fill in his eyebrows, though. I think I'd do that right now. Just because I feel like goth boys are just, like, intense. You know what I mean? So everything's got to be dark and, like, solid and all that good stuff. So I'm just packing it in. You know, giving him some dark, brooding brows, as it were. This is essentially the Batman sans mask look. You know? Just, like, the dark eyes and nothing else going on. Get in, get them brows nice and dork, like his soul. Oh, I'm wearing a bra because I don't care. Is that... I just ate some pizza. Man, this went a lot longer than I thought it was going to go on. Oh, there it is. Look at that boy. He looks like freaking Johnny Depp. I was going to give him eyeliner, but once again, I'm very limited with the space I have on Gage's eyelid, so I just decided to give him a little upside-down devil cross on his face, because that's pretty edgy, right? People always love Satanism. I don't know what they're into. This part was also very difficult. Gage is just an incredibly sensitive, delicate little dandelion. So he just can't handle... I was smelling my fingers there because I was like, oh, do my fingers smell like shit? Which is crazy that this far in I was asking him if my fingers smell like shit, considering I've been holding his face for like 20 minutes at this point. But again, Gage is a trooper, if nothing else. Look at him. Look at that. Got a lot going on. And yet, very little. Had him put that piercing in to kind of polish off the look. He's feeling himself. Whenever you put makeup on Gage, he turns into like a cockatoo. Look at him. And then I just kind of start fucking with his hair a little bit. I don't really know what I was going for here. I just wanted it to be messy. But Gage's hair kind of only goes in like one direction right now. So I did what I could. And like always, I just pretended like I knew what I was doing. And because the products I was using smelt like coconut, I think he believed that I knew what I was doing. Yeah, I was like, yeah, this is what I want, but really, I don't know what I wanted. There's not a lot you can do with the e-boy's hair. It's usually just greasy and messy, and so I had to make it look greasy and try to make it look messy, but it was so neat. It just wouldn't tussle, you know what I mean? It was so frustrating. Then I brushed him a little bit, or freaking brushed his dang old little head, but it just didn't do what I wanted, you know? It's so frustrating. So I just kind of fricked his hair around a little bit. Look at him. Delicate little princess, little baby, little delicate baby. I did nothing with his hair from beginning to end of this picture. From beginning to end of this video, I did nothing with Gage's hair. I twirled it around a little bit.
Tight on the like butt and thigh area, and then kind of like bell bottom. Oh, actually, that kind of works. Yeah, that kind of totally works.
Look, guys.
I kind of like it. Okay, so I wanted to go goth with Brittany. She's already goth. I wanted to dress her the way I would dress as a girl. That's also goth. So what I did was go bohemian, because I think that that's so different than what she normally likes to do, and I thought she'd feel really crazy in it, and I thought it'd be really crazy to see her in it. So I tried to go for, like, a festival girl, bohemian. She's got the pretty makeup on, the little, like, cut top, and the, like, crazy pants that you'd look at and you'd find at, like, what's that store called?
Earthbound.
Earthbound. Basically, I wanted you to look like you're really into mushrooms and rocks. And I think that I've achieved that. For someone who has zero experience doing this kind of thing, I think I did a pretty good job achieving the look I wanted to achieve. The cute earthy moons.
I like quinoa.
What's your name?
Juniper.
This is Juniper. Juniper is an Aries.
I'll fucking kill you.
She's all sass, and she will cheat on you. She is not monogamous.
You know what you need? You need rose quartz. That's why you're finding all the bad men, because you don't have any rose quartz in your bedroom.
Okay, so for Gage, I really wanted to go like goth e-boy, but we went to the thrift store, so I was really working with limited materials, and the accessories are mine. So I gave him like the short cutoff pants, and like he's got the long black socks. And I just gave him some grungy...
Hold on, hold on.
some grungy makeup with a little, oh, ear horns. With a little upside down cross, you know, because he loves Jesus. And just the, you know, it's like, it's very classic, like early 2000s. Like, this guy listens to Good Charlotte. And he says emo's not dead, like, all the time. This is the guy that Machine Gun Kelly wishes he was. And I just feel like the horns were really just what tied it all together. And yeah, that's really pretty. Just grungy, gothy e-boy. I would have gone so much harder if we had a bigger budget, but...
I think...
You're clearly feeling yourself.
It's a vibe.
It is a vibe.
It's a vibe. It's
definitely a vibe.
I'm a hippie. Look at my feet.
I mean, now the feet thing would be on brand for this girl. All right. Reveal's done. How do you feel?
I feel different.
You look so different.
These pants are very soft. I will say wearing white makes me want to die.
It's not.
I hate wearing white.
For my, dude, spoken even, like a true god.
Even for my wedding, I wouldn't dare to put white on my body. Let me just disclaimer first. If you dress like this, I have literally nothing against you. It's just not my aesthetic whatsoever. And it's so far from the way I normally dress that it's, like, making me a little angry. So if I say something that's kind of mean, it's not personal. It's, like, just, it's so weird and different to dress, like, outside of your, like, normal vibe. I would never dress like this in 1 million years. And I'm almost 30. Like, and I feel like this is a very normal way for a grown woman to dress. And I probably get weird.
I know many women that dress like
this. Yeah, I do, too. And I'm, like, and that's... That's great. And I probably get weirder looks dressing the way I dress now than I would get weirder looks dressing like this, because people would be like, what the fuck is happening with you? But I think Gage did a good job with what he was going for.
I think honestly, I crushed it. I think I did a really good job for where I was trying to get to.
Yeah, I think you fucking
And it took me for fucking ever.
Yeah. We were like I said, we were working with very limited supplies.
Like, because these on a rack, we went shopping in a not like hip area.
Yeah,
like,
right,
not
right.
Like there's a ton of selection.
It's like for moms.
And this on a rack next to all 60-year-old women's, white women's clothing, these don't look particularly bohemian.
I mean, I think with like on just a younger person,
like on the rack.
Yeah.
Like in that setting, it's hard to find this.
Yeah.
So that took me forever. And then the white top honestly took me a long time to find too. I just couldn't find like a classic top.
I think you did a good job.
I wanted to get one that had more frill and floof on like the arm.
But I think you just did a good job. Thanks, I feel great. Ah, that cramp on my foot. Juniper wouldn't get a cramp. She probably drinks like.
She does yoga for sure.
She's so flexible, and I'm not. How do you feel?
Honestly, I feel very cool.
Yeah.
Number one, wearing rings makes you very animated with your hands. I feel like Jack Sparrow doing a lot of like.
Yeah.
Like if I wore rings, I would be very like. Yeah. I don't want to wear rings, so I don't want to draw attention to my fingers.
Okay. I think it's metal to eat your fingernails. That's metal as fuck.
Yes. I don't think that I would ever dress. I mean, take the horns out
of it. Yeah, that was just for funsies.
Right, I'm gonna take them off, actually, just to kind of make the look more as I would go out.
Yeah.
I don't think that I would ever rock this particular look, even though I want to be more goth.
Yeah.
This feels 2000s goth.
This is as close as I could get to e-boy shopping at a thrift store.
Yeah.
It was, like I said, it was a struggle.
But the,
this shirt but I the found makeup, in the women's section.
The makeup's honestly pretty cool, and I kind of dig the
you
necklace.
Should wear more jewelry.
I dig. I feel it's nice to feel
different. Yeah.
It's nice to feel accessorized.
Kind of liberating a little bit.
It's liberating. Do you feel like? Because you feel like I feel like I can't be judged because it's not me being judged. It's not. It's the projection of me.
Yeah. It's Damien.
This is Damien, not Gage. But at the same time, like it just feels cool. Like I like wearing things. Yeah. I like having this on.
I feel like feel like I'm wearing a costume. I feel like I'm, like, role-playing. Like,
and that's, it's so crazy how just changing the style you're in can make you feel like a different person.
If I had the time and the money and everybody in my life was willing to it, I would put everybody that I know in golf clothes.
Yeah.
And you know what? Wow. You should also not be like, oh, you know what? I'm too old to wear that. Fuck it, dude. We're literally, like I've said before, on a fucking spinning dirt rock. Are you really gonna tell yourself that because you're in your 40s you can't wear a crop top? No, you're not. Okay, you're just not. Nuclear war could happen at any fucking minute. Mommy, what do you think? I'm different.
Your mom's gonna love this
look. I feel like I'm wearing like a diaper up here. I feel like my boobs look great. I feel like they look bad.
Dude. I think they look really good.
I feel like when I'm sitting down, I just look very, like...
Can you pull it down? Like, is there cleavage possible to come out of it?
My boobs will fall out, so no.
Oh.
What do you guys think? It looks so different. I feel like these people are, like, siblings. And yeah. They're so different. It's like, Mom, Damien's using my fucking hair straightener again.
Just, like, hissing.
Mom, Damien's hissing again.
I just put my like AirPods in and just fucking crazy God. Metal. Meditation. you're getting the character. Yeah. Now. Well, anything else you want to say?
I hope you guys enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun doing this.
If you have the opportunity, get a friend. Do this with your friend because this is so fun.
Whatever your normal style is, just go the complete opposite.
Honestly, fucking randomize it.
That's true too.
Fucking put it on a spinner.
Yeah. And if your normal style is like this, just try goth one time. I promise, it's so much fun. You don't have to stay goth, but it'll be fun.
Yar.
So if you guys liked and enjoyed this video, please give us one of these.
Oh, I just realized I look like a prisoner.
They don't wear that anymore.
They do.
They don't.
I've been a prisoner. This guy, Damien, I've been in prison.
Damien was in lockup for like 24 hours. And his rich daddy fucking bailed him out.
And I was like, I'm so hard now.
Okay. Give us one of these. Maybe if you're seeing us for the first time, subscribe. Follow us on Instagram and TikTok under the same name.
Hell yeah.
This one right here. And that's basically it. We're just having fun.
Because tonight will be the night that I will fall for you over and